from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Tune in for an informative and enlightening program that delivers all you need to know on topical issues and current. This is the Discourse with JIMI DISU.
Yeah, you're welcome to this Sunday's edition of the Discourse with JIMI DISU. How has your week been? First of all, very quickly, one or two personal things. Want to express my condolence to the Kioro family. My friend, Sheson Kioro, lost his sister, Mrs. Fasanya, as they call her. We lost her during the week. The funeral will be sometime, maybe next week or so. May she rest in peace. Also, today is my brother's birthday. The guy immediately after me wrote to me, Disu. He's a lawyer. He's 50 today. I wish him a happy birthday. All God's blessings and wishes. So, for his friends, I think wrote to me, I saw him icing some drinks this afternoon. They can quickly run down there and get something cold to drink. Okay. Now, how has the week been? Of course, the week, we still have this chibok, this girl's abduction problem. We still have it with us. On Thursday, the president announced that he had set up some kind of committee to sift the information and advise him on what to do. I don't know how to describe my reaction to that. It's a bit more than embarrassing. This is strictly, I don't know why we run our governments by committees. We used to set up a committee for almost everything in sight. The truth is, you need a strong intelligence and military action to get these boys out. Let me give you an example. I remember in the 80s, I remember in the 80s, when Buhari, when he had a sense that our funds were with some of the politicians, and Diko ran to the UK, he didn't go through any diplomatic channel to get. He got some Israeli guerrillas and whatever to put him in a crate and bring him down here. Okay? I mean, that was one of my best moments as a Nigerian, that I have a country that is action-based. You know? I tend to believe very strongly that there must be some mercenaries or groups out there who specialize in these things. Hire them and they will bring those girls home. You understand? All this idea of setting up a committee, Femi Falana is that. What does Femi Falana know about intelligence? What does he know about Chibok?
Did he have anything to do with it?
Exactly. What does Femi, what do you want to go? So we keep doing these things. I think these are just things to just supposedly placate people. But we don't need to be placated. We want those girls back home. And we want to see some concrete action. You know, the setting up committees. And just in the papers this morning at about 3 a.m., you know, they have this habit of looking at 3 a.m. to read papers online. I saw somewhere where it said in the punch that the first lady said that, if they don't get the girls back by Sunday, she was going to demonstrate. She was going to go lead a demonstration to the Borno State governor. Listen to that. She's going to lead a demonstration to the Senate president. And that she was going to lead a demonstration to the president himself, the husband, that they both sleep on the same bed. And I said to myself, all this grandstanding is not going to produce. People are demonstrating because they want action. They are not demonstrating for. It's not as if it's a demonstration that is going to bring these girls. We don't want any grandstanding. We want a concrete military plan. And every day is important. Now you say you're going to set up some committee and then you're going to inaugurate them on Tuesday. You're going to waste another 4 days in between that time. You know, so many things. I don't understand what's going on. I honestly don't understand what's going on. If anybody understands what's going on, I would be glad for somebody to tell me. You know, I'd be glad for somebody to tell me. Then all kinds of propaganda are coming in place. No, the girls were not actually missing. Maybe they're not missing. Maybe they don't exist. Come on. The whole world knows that these girls are missing. Fine, we might not have a compromise. We might not be able to say these are number, but also we need some concerted action. The president is going to have a media chat tonight. I think it's going to be on all the network stations. We will listen to it. It might spring a surprise. Who knows? But I hope it's not going to be the same old thing. This is not, we don't want rhetoric. We want action. You know, it's even better for the government not to say anything and just say that, look, calm down. We have a plan. We can't tell you the plan for security reasons, and we are working on it. Rather than setting up a 20, 30 man with Femi Falano and some pump sex somewhere and so on and so forth to furnish government with information on the... This is not how things are done. It is definitely not how things are done. I mean, am I right or wrong, dear Bunmi?
Well, I agree with you. Because one thing, one of my grouses is that when the incident happened at Borno State,
yes.
The teacher that was it a principal or the teacher or whatever that handed the children over to all these men.
Yes.
They came in vehicles, buses, and then you handed them over without number one asking for the identity or counter checking whether it's true that
it could have been at gunpoint. Most likely was at gunpoint.
And then at one point, the kids will see, you know, we are talking about teenagers, and 200 plus teenagers won't see gun, and then move towards the vehicle. Some of them will run away with, they couldn't have killed all of them. That notwithstanding, most of the information, because with a freedom of information bill and all that,
yes.
It seems the press here, they're not getting enough feedbacks. You get more on CNN, and when you listen to all this foreign media, they tell you that where these girls were likely taken,
yes.
Was this enclave that nobody can penetrate. They out of the Borno State, they have already carved out a niche for themselves, well guarded. And now if you had all these helicopters and things to fish the girls out, the girls are already like human shield. You can't bomb anywhere, and they won't make themselves a sort of sitting target.
Okay.
So what you have now is people who are holding us to ransom and all that. And then what you want to do now is surprise them. All this guerrilla thing. Most of our military people are politicians. They are no longer doing what they are trained for. And they are so they all have pot bellies and all that. Like someone said, you can't take a soldier from one of these military people from roadblocks and ask them to go
to
Sambisa Forest. That he would just resign, remove his uniform, and go and spend the rest of the money that he had. So we have to all these marching. We were buying protest marches. Are to draw a sort of attention
yes.
And sympathy
yes.
To what is going on. And you see the mothers crying, most of them taking their clothes. There was an incident that happened that I thought I have only a child, a daughter.
Okay.
I thought she was lost, and we got our information crossed, and I went to her room. I said, I have not seen this girl again, no. I'm going to die in this room with her. And some of these my parents, there's a father that has seven children amongst all these people. You know, mothers notwithstanding, the nation is being treated as a joke. I was discussing this with someone yesterday, and he said, oh, these people are just drawing attention to themselves. With how many people's lives? How many people's lives?
Well, okay, I mean, I put the cart before the horse because I was still in the before I got
okay.
For our listeners at home, of course, I have in the studio, dear Bunmi, she's Ms. Bunmi Shofola. She's a journalist. She's been a journalist for ages. I met her at the profession. In fact, I must quickly say, for those who think, you know, there's no kind of funny thing they said. Some people said maybe there's something going on. They don't know that you're my big sister. They don't know that we got inspired by you when you were doing things in Happy Home and so on in the 70s.
So we can't have any incest.
Well, we can manage it. Right? And we can try.
No.
Ali Yewo.
Yeah, no. Oh, what test?
Okay, listeners, we have Jim Bunmi in the house. Initially, when we thought we were going to have, you know, because she has a column that she's been writing for almost about. That particular column, dear Bunmi, is about what is from Punch.
From Punch.
From Happy Home.
From Happy Home. Then it got to, when I got to Daily Times, Lagos,
yes.
Lagos Weekend, I changed it to Dear Auntie Gina.
Okay,
that ran in Lagos Weekend too, until I came back to Vanguard and then went back to Dear Bunmi.
So you've been an agony aunt for close to 40
years.
40 years.
Yes.
I mean, you have a lot of experience. I have one or two problems I'm going to discuss with you that I have.
It's only God that can solve your problems.
It's only God that can. I'm in love with one or two people, and I don't know. Shaking late, little on
I think you're in love with yourself.
Okay, we'll get on to that, but we really do need to talk a little bit more about this this girl's... what is the sense that you get? I mean, as a media person, you're a journalist, you've covered loads and loads of stories, you've seen various regimes, right from the time of Gawan, Shagari, and so on and so forth. What kind of... What's your real reaction, your inner and honest reaction to government reaction to this crisis? What does your inner feeling tell you?
Well, I think government is just taking everyone for granted.
Okay.
That, you know, tell them whatever they want to listen to, and they'll accept it. We have passed all that stage. Initially, when this thing happened, we were told that 100 odd people were hijacked, and that they've recouped most of them, leaving about...
The military said they had to recoup all of them.
Yes. Okay. No, almost all of them.
Yes.
That only a few were left. Until the parents started shouting that they hadn't seen any of their children and all that. All this misinformation, then they tell us they are doing something. You read in the papers that helicopters are circling the place. They've enlisted help from America, from Britain. Nothing is happening. And then, of course, these people will sit in one place with all these girls eating toad and fura de nunu. All the girls would have been distributed like they said.
Like it was reported in the Guardian UK.
Yes. Mm. And if that were true, we are just praying that all of them will be found. But that's a lot of wishful thinking, if we were to be frank with ourselves. And then I'm just praying that these girls are not kids. Because when you abduct kids at age 2, 3, by the time they are 5, 6 years, they've forgotten everything about their background. Mm.
But these are teenagers.
And then they too, we hope, will be plotting on how they want to come back home, wherever it is that they will take them.
Mm.
Because this is where this age, anything could happen.
But
before that happens, what does the government want to do? Or what do they want to do? They can't do anything, because who will bail the cat? Who will march into the forest
to
face these maniacs who don't care about their lives?
But something
has to be done. But what could be done?
Okay, look.
Jimmy.
Yes.
All these three northern state governors, you keep on blaming the federal government and they have their security votes too. What are they doing?
Okay, what will they put the money on?
All these youths that don't have jobs, they could use them as surveillance people. Maybe by... Before this happened, they should have done that. What did they spend their security vote on up till now? Because this thing has been simmering.
See,
it didn't just happen overnight.
Yes, but let me ask you something. You know, I also say to myself, what is the government doing for the mothers of these children? Are they being counseled? Are they being put in a particular place? Are they being counseled? Are they giving them concrete step-by-step information?
They are not. They are not.
Let us take an example from what happened in the Malaysian airline, whatever. They put them in a hotel. They were counseling them. There's something, you feel is slightly better if you're in a group. They counsel
them. And then you share your problem.
They bump them over to the Philistines on that. And it's very sad.
Oh.
Very, very sad. Now, let me ask you. Being a woman, why do you think the First Lady, for example, says she wants to lead a demonstration to the Senate President, to the governor, and then to lead
I don't have a clue, Jimmy. I really don't have a clue.
You must have a clue, you're a woman.
No, but about what she's doing.
Yes.
What does she hope to achieve by all that?
I don't know, but that's what I'm asking you. You're a woman.
You have to come out and tell us what you have done, not what you are going to do. What you are going to do, everybody else on the street in Nigeria, abroad, you know, we have these people.
Everybody is
doing that. So we don't need all that. We want positive action. Like you said, maybe counseling and all that. But you have to have all these, like you said before, that all these snipers and mercenaries and things that fish out people that are lost. Maybe you should...
You should contact them.
But you must have concrete plans. Not that, I'm going to and do what?
Just dance
on the street. What would that achieve? Nothing. We've had all those marches and all prayers. We've had prayers, now we want action.
Okay, before we go, we'll take a break and then we'll go to, because there are loads of people that have their problems, they want to ask you questions. And you'll have to answer
like questions.
Like me. I've increased the number of people I'm in love with to 3 now, from 2, while I've been on it. But the other thing I'd like to ask you, you know, being a media person too, do you believe that it might be necessary for us to always have a president who has some kind of military background? Would that help?
It should
because
help.
Do you think Obasanjo would have handled this issue this way?
I don't believe it.
Oh, okay, or maybe I should use
that. He wouldn't handle it this way, but he would have handled it the military way. And then, you see, you will need a president who can marry the two.
Yes.
Maybe have a bit of military background and all. But
I think it helps.
It helps, but it gives them a bit of a big head too. Look at that, the Yanko governor.
Okay, Yanko, yes.
You know, they think they can talk above our heads and get away with it. So you have to have a bit of this and a bit of that.
But I obviously do believe that I think that it would be good for us to have a well-rounded president in future. Somebody who has some military background and so on and so forth. Because I get a sense.
And someone who is very assertive.
Very assertive.
Yes. You don't want someone to just come and be droning on the microphone and sending you to sleep with his voice. We want someone to face us in front of
us. Who is sending you to sleep with
his voice? I'm not saying anything. We want some.
Sis, let me ask you. How come a man's voice will send you to sleep? What are you?
Don't turn it into something. This is a serious issue.
I know, but you know, sometimes
you've got to cry to laugh.
You try to laugh and lighten ourselves a little bit. Yes. We'll take a short break. Florence, you've eaten 7 minutes of my time. So I'm going to eat 7 minutes of Afrologist's time. Okay. Now, what kind of music would you like to listen to whilst we take a break, and then people can now come up with all their problems that they have?
Well, any good music from the 60s, 70s,
70s.
You know.
Oh, okay, all right. We'll look for something. It's still the Discourse with JIMI DISU. To be part of this program, you can call in 0909-217-2973. Yeah, you can tweet at Classic FM 973. You can send in a text to 33973. And you can call in at 07087656030. And for those of you who probably have an idea of what my number is, you can send me a text if you can't get through to that. But don't call me, I can't pick your calls. So we'll listen to some music for a very short period because we're running for time, and then we'll be right back.
This is The Discourse with JIMI DISU.
Yeah, we're back to the discourse. Yeah, we're back to the discourse with JIMI DISU. We've had some reactions. Taiwo Obi says we've had prayers, now we want action. He's repeating what he's saying. And Adigwega is a regular listener. He says it in Yoruba that kukuru to jefo inwe for lower, that the people are only deceiving the citizens of this country now. We don't know which people are deceiving us now, whether those who say the girls are missing or those who say the girls cannot be found. Well, we'll get around to that. Also, we had a caller that where's that? Okay, 40 years and counting. That's for you. And he says, what keeps Miss Bumishofala going? Has she ever repeated any article? That the articles that you write, because let me quickly add, you write Dear Bunmi.
Yes.
You write yours sincerely.
I do.
Is there a third one that you write?
On Saturdays, I write Weekend Blues.
You write Weekend Blues. Now, I'm going to catch you on this one. Is there anyone that you wrote that you didn't use your name?
I'm not answering that question.
Let me tell you, I'm suspecting. Are you the one who writes Trina Quinta? You're not?
No, I'm not.
What about IE, the one in Prime People? It's gone now, so
no,
we can't
I'm
talk
not,
about
I'm
it.
Not.
You didn't write IE. IE was a very nice caller.
No,
I didn't. I keep asking me why I did it, but I've tried to. I tried all kinds of things. I bribed him. I got him drunk. He never told me.
No, not me. I can tell you. I assure you.
That. Okay. But how? Okay. 40 years. I mean, of course, being matured, you're able to answer a lot of these questions. But do you actually take? Does it take you so much time to think about what answer to give them? you know, these agony questions that you get?
Because, well, it doesn't really, because I've been doing it for, like you said, above close to four decades.
Yes.
And then you discover that with people, you like by the time I got here, you bent my ears about all the problems you had, and we banded solutions and all that. And then I read a lot, and then all this, I've turned myself into a sort of counselor, which I am. And, you know, when all these problems happen, and then I get the difficult ones, I discuss with a few people. But invariably, you discover that people have more or less the same problems.
Which is the most common problem that you have?
My marital, relationship problems.
Oh, that's marital problems.
Marital,
yes.
Well, mostly relationship, not to do with your work or anything. But relationships, either married, separated, courtship and all that, relationship problems are the most.
But definitely relationships that we have these days are not the same that you had in, you know.
How would you know?
I mean the basis of relationships. The technology has taken part of the shine out of it. Waiting for that long letter to come in the post. Absence makes the heart go fonder. There's no absence anymore. You can see on Skype, on Twitter, and so on and so forth.
I know, but the basic rules are still there. People are still as deceptive as they were in those days.
Why did you say deceptive?
It's true, because there was a time we were having a discussion at a friend's place, and the mom was just shaking her head. That was ages ago. And she said, "You, the little girls, you talk too much. Most of these things you do, we've done worse, but nobody would ever hear."
What kind of things do you think she was referring to?
I wouldn't know.
But tell me now, you are
like you are committing adultery.
Okay.
Stealing your husband's money.
Oh, okay.
And things like that. You know that husband stealing from his wife. You know, men do that all the time.
No, we don't steal from our wives.
You do? Oh, a lot
of
our
wives are steal from us.
Yeah.
Now all the monies are in the ATM. They keep changing the PIN number.
When your wife brings money into the house, you sneak into her wardrobe or her briefcase. You know the combination numbers. A lot of men steal from their wives.
Really?
And a lot of men lie that they are helping wives to purchase property and all that. And divert the money. And there's nothing you can do. So men as deceptive as women, if not more. But we women, whenever anything happens, we shout. But you men are what we call a bush and ujajemuti.
But let me ask you. Nowadays, the younger people do find it very, very difficult to settle down. You know, way back in the day, the economics of society, the economics of living was much, much better than what you have now. What do you think should be the priority of today's young girl? What should be her priority?
It's very sad that today's young people are too exposed. You have the internet, you have the television, you have the discussions among the internet mostly, because most of them go on the porn sites all of the time.
Yeah.
If you can get porn sex free and all that, when you start a relationship now, you want to measure what you've seen on the on your porn site.
When I say measure, you want to measure the man's performance with what you've seen on the site.
I'm talking about the men. I'm talking about the men.
I just wanted to be clear.
This is a serious issue, Jimmy.
I know.
Making it sound as if it's a
It's not a real target. I'm not to. Okay, but go on.
It's true. So by the time you have all this sulfate of a debauchery, and then you meet this small innocent thing, and then you want to teach how, and then you just say, if I can't get what I want from her, let me go back to my phone side. And then, you know, the vicious cycle continues.
Yeah.
And then the girls too, of course, because most of, you see, parents should be careful of whom they expose their young children to.
Mm-hmm.
Go with Uncle Jimmy to auntie's birthday, and then Uncle Jimmy will lead the poor lamb to the slaughter.
Why did you say Uncle Lawrence or...
No, seriously.
Uncle Sam or something.
Ben, by the time, you see, most of these girls don't have parental supervision.
Supervision, yes.
And
yes.
By the time they are, I was just laughing about 2 weeks ago when you said when you were 16 you didn't know anything about sex and all that, when you were discussing one of the problems my page.
Yes.
By the time these girls are 14, 15, they know everything that you want to do, any average woman to know about sex, they already do.
But that's one side of the equation. The other side of the equation also is that most of the boys who are their own age have finding it very, very difficult to settle down. So you find that most of them want to go for elder men, for older men, or most of them want to have a kick on the side to balance up and things like that.
The women?
Yes, the women, yes.
Yeah.
So how does one handle that?
How does one handle that? Because you have taught them how to behave, the men. Because a girl would innocently go after a worldly wise man, thinking that she would eventually get married to him. And before you blink your eye, he's getting married. So the girls now, they have a contingency plans. That's why most of them have two or three.
A backup.
Two or three boyfriends waiting in the wings. There was a time a wedding was cancelled because the guy sort of reneged on his promise and went his way.
Yes.
Between three months, the guy was already sending out another card.
It's happening again. No?
And there are weddings these days that do happen. Months later, everything is finished.
In spite
of all these big society weddings that they had.
We have a caller on the line. Somebody has a problem, I'm sure. Hello, good afternoon. This is the Discourse.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Yes, very quickly, what's your question, reaction, or whatever?
Actually, I want to just contribute to this program. I think it's Ono.
Okay, Ono. Oh, yes, please go on.
And that of your guest.
Yes.
Are you going to react to it?
Yes.
When you said you don't understand why the president is asking, is creating a committee.
Yeah, go on.
Hello.
Yeah, go on.
You know, you should know something. Creating a committee and leadership style is related. Are you with me?
Yes, I'm with you.
It has become our tradition and culture.
Does it make it right?
No, but yes, go on. Talk very quickly because we run out of time, yes.
It has become our tradition and culture.
Yes.
Once you are a president or a governor,
yes,
it happens to create a committee to look at it and advise you. But I tell you, leadership is a relative thing. Everybody has their own style. For instance, now, if somebody will have a new short temper because the president, they will not create a committee. All they will do is put in the position as the commander in chief of the armed forces. This is what I want to do. That is the quality that OPK has. Are you with me?
Okay.
But then, it has to rely on him. Look at the OPK massacre.
Okay.
And look at what we do now in Venice. These are things you should look at. The president is trying to be moderate here. Already, a lot of people are crying that he's telling the genocide.
Okay, all right. We have a sense of what you're saying. Thank you very much.
One of the things that we should allow the president to work and that security issues.
How long should we give him?
No, let him finish. So we should be setting up a committee 3 weeks after the girls are missing. And you want to run a country by committee. You want to take every action by consensus. Okay, we've gotten your point. No, excuse me, we've got to just... Okay, what's your reaction to that? What's your reaction to that? Yes, it was for you.
No,
not for
me. What I'm saying, how long are you going to set up committees for?
Almost 3 weeks after the girls have been...
And what... How long will the committee sit for before they start to implement all these things? What it has nothing to do with committees. It has
exactly.
Something to do with...
That's
what you said initially, that we are sick and tired of all this. This is not a tea party, and it's not a political
rally. It's not the first subsidy issue.
It's an issue. So what has the committee...
Okay, you put somebody like Falano in the committee. What does he know?
You saw a wild iron running wild, and then you said you are cleaning your gun. What for? By the time you finish, the thing has escaped.
No, I think I'd like to disagree with Ono When we say we have a commander-in-chief, we want a commander-in-chief. Action should be immediate. We need somebody who can pull the trigger. You know, action should be immediate. You don't run this First and Second World Wars against Hitler were not prosecuted by Winston Churchill by committees. You will have war strategy things and so on and so on. You have war rooms and so on and so forth where you strategize and so on and so forth. But it's not done by inaugurating a committee 3 weeks after the girls have voted away. We have another caller. Hello, good afternoon.
Hello.
Good afternoon, this is Discourse. Who's calling, please?
Good afternoon. My name is Saeed Ladeza.
Yes.
It's unfortunate the way we take things.
Yes.
First, the president is efficient. It's about you, like you say.
Yes.
But, sincerely, from our point of perspective, sometimes when he gets too much, he becomes another problem too.
Mm-hmm.
The other day, one diplomat made a comment that the federal government is not supporting the North and all that.
Yes.
That's a statement that can cause chaos, that can cause us to divide in the country. And the president, nobody is talking about that. I expect the president to issue a statement that man should immediately
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. Yes.
On the other hand, I still have concern. The issue of Boko Haram and all that, children and all that, hello?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Turn down the volume of your radio. We can't hear you. You know what you'll do? I think maybe you should call back and then turn down the volume of your radio because we're not picking you well here.
Hello?
Turn down the volume of your radio and then call back. We can't pick you well here. Yes, the essence of what is... It's gone. Okay. The essence of what he's saying... In truth, what he's talking about is actually trying to talk about what the other gentleman said.
I know, but
and so that white patience is a virtue.
Of what we are discussing today,
yes.
Missing children,
yes. I know, he's also making a reference to that.
I know.
And then there's also, what was trying to say is that whilst being patient is a virtue, there are some things that actually do need some quick action. I think we do need some quick action. We shouldn't shy away from saying so, because in truth, we don't know when all this is going to end. We don't know who are the
mothers.
Next set of
don't
people.
Know when the children are coming home.
The mothers don't know when the children are coming home. Look,
their beds are empty.
Look at the Yaya bomb blast. Now you had the first bomb blast. You still had the second bomb blast. What the government reaction?
Look at what happened at Abuja. All the CCTVs.
Yes.
Missing, where you could detect all these people planting bombs. They couldn't locate where they put all the CCTVs that cost billions to install. It's atrocious. It's a disaster.
My God.
You know, when I saw that, I said, what kind of country? Because, of course, all these, I'm sure most of the people who helped to install the CCTVs know how to remove the thing and then reinstall and collect money again.
But we have a World Economic Forum coming up next week. And the reaction of the government has been to close down, you know, they've said offices should shut down.
Because of that,
schools should shut down. Mm-hmm. Even private offices that have a large volume of workers should shut down. Do you shut down a city because you want to have a three-day meeting?
Oh.
Is that ever done?
I'm asking you,
but you're more senior than I am.
I don't. Well, we are more exposed. But
I'm not more exposed, though.
Even the conference that you are supposed to be having that is vital to the future of this country, they are going to put a stop on that for days so that this summit would go.
Oh, okay. The national conference is going to go up.
Yeah, for 1 week. And then that's why it's being extended for another week. And we won't know that. Would we
lose anything by just admitting that, look, it's just not conducive for us to have this?
For now.
We will
do it another time. Why? Well, is it annoying? Is it as urgent as finding all these missing people?
I don't know.
That's the question we should ask ourselves.
Okay,
we have a priority wrong.
Let me read some of the reactions we have here. Some here says, please let us understand that there is no half state of emergency. All schools should be closed, only hospitals, markets, and banks should be open. All the governors should be removed and full military action to take place. This is Ibrahim from Ibrahim. He wants all the governors removed. Somebody said, hello, when you mentioned Buhari, I cried. I vote every election year for him. I pray every day that he should be president. Then this country will move forward. This is propaganda. Yeah. So another person says, Jimmy Jonathan must wake up and solve this security problem and let us have peace in dear Nigeria. His name is Rotimi Paul. And on tweets, we have been praying since 1960. Prayers without action is useless. Yeah. Try praying for a job without sending out CVs and messages. Olajide Fasha says, Nigerian army that is poorly motivated can go after Boko Haram. Body language is that politicians should go into the forest. What he means here is it possible that the army could be, you know, could just be like taking a backseat and saying, okay, why don't you politicians go solve the problem? Could that be happening?
How will they solve the problem? Is the military that is supposed
they are
to go
supposed
there
to, yes,
and fight
yes.
fire with
yes.
fire?
Yes. Mm. there's one here. He says, dear Bunmi is on right now. That your sexy neighbor has been a distraction must be dealt with. I don't know who that is. Okay, we are going to take another break. I really must let you catch your breath. Oh, we have a caller. Let's take a caller very quickly. Yes, good afternoon. Good afternoon. This is the Discourse. Good afternoon. How are you doing?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
you're back on the line. Yes, very quickly, sir.
Yeah. First, the chief security officer.
Yes.
Of the organization presently.
Yes.
Sincerely, I think a lot of things should be a lot of questions you ask, if you ask me.
Yes. To ask or to answer?
Yeah, a lot of questions to answer. Right?
Oh, okay. I thought that was it. Yes.
Unfortunately, Adagi was left to make this single show. It was in his tenure that this Boko Haram issue came to the first instance. Now he's back there again and all. And I don't even know. If you ask me, I believe there are external forces that the United States of America or the United Nations will be to call themselves. I don't know. What is their problem about this nation dividing in 2015? And I pray we don't play into their hands. We don't play to the script. It's unfortunate we are caring about things. We need to call ourselves together in this country. The strength of this nation lies in our unity. Together.
Okay, so thank you.
I think we, the leaders of this nation, should throw away their selfish desires and come together and fight to wait for move forward. If you ask me, I have a strong belief that this nation has those that designed this nation to be the leading.
Okay, all right. We'll have to take it there because you've taken, you're almost becoming the guest of the program itself. But thank you very much for your contribution. One of these days I'll drag you in. But very patriotic thing that you have said. Do you have any reaction to what you said?
I sort of agree with it, but you know, like I said, this is not the flavor of the moment.
The flavor of the moment is we are very impatient. We want to see something concrete being done. I think it's necessary for us, you know, for the government to understand that Nigeria has become a much more sophisticated country than using 1960, 1970 tactics, propaganda rubbish. It's not going to work anymore. You understand? There's no hiding place.
When
okay?
you keep on recycling old politicians anyway, this is what you get.
You reckon?
I do. You don't have all these firebrand young politicians. Whenever they come out, of course, they kick them out of the way with their cunning ways, and then you bring all these oldies back, singing the same song year in, year out. Well, it's not going to help anybody. Mm. And then we keep on talking about revolution and where will the revolution come from? We now see the implication of all these revolutionary things. When you are planning things, by the time you get out of the place, Twitters have gone round that you are in the midst of this, Bunmi said that, and all that. No. Whatever you have decided, it's gone down the drain. So, I don't know.
I think let's take one caller before we take a very short break. Hello. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. How are you doing?
I'm going to actually go on that break so I can speak to people.
I can't hear you, please.
I said, I'd rather you go on that way. I'd rather you tell you what I want to say off air.
Oh, that will. Okay. All right. No, don't hold the line. We'll talk later. Okay, so we'll take a short break. What kind of music can I play you?
Just play whatever you like.
Something to brighten you up a bit. Do you like contemporary music, Nigerian music?
Yes, of course.
Or this bumper to bumper, Kwakurumo and all this.
I like Davido, whatever you do.
Who is Davido?
But anything he plays is okay.
Okay, do you have Davido? Okay, we'll play Davido for you.
I like it.
It's the Discourse with JIMI DISU. Keep your calls coming in, your texts and your whatever. I will be right back. Yes, we're back to the Discourse with JIMI DISU, and I still have dear Bunmi in the house, Miss Mishofala. We will go on the last just about 10 more minutes. Now, one of the things that aside from the issue of the girls back again to the home front, is you do find now that a lot of women are harassed by their bosses. They're harassed day in, day out to keep their jobs and so on and so forth. How, because I've had many people send in questions to say, look, how do you handle a recalcitrant boss who would try to block your progress, you know?
That happens a lot. It's very unfortunate.
Did you face anything like that in your own profession?
Journalism, you can
joke. You slap him in the newsroom.
Nothing as serious as that, because journalists are just men, male or female.
Male or female,
we call them gentlemen of the press, and most of the time you are on the field. And but in offices, female harassment, it works both ways, you know. But mostly young females are the ones that are being harassed.
Mm.
And I don't know, it's a very, very complex issue. Because some of these ladies, they use themselves as baits
to attract. Okay.
Them. Most of them attract. You don't call them. You don't call that harassment again, because they ask to be harassed. Mm. You know, they flaunt whatever they have to get whatever they want, and it's mostly that. Because if you have a lot of choice that at your doorstep begging you to take, you don't harass anybody as such.
So
there is harassment, but at the same time, there are people who use themselves as bait.
Well, those ones won't complain, but you do.
Oh, they do complain when they have competition. When they have competition in the office, there's always, because it's.
But what happens if, for example, a man is harassed? Let's say let's assume that I work in an office.
Or in a school, and the principal is harassing me.
It happens
all the time.
And my female boss says that, I should come and work overtime weekends. And I don't intend to do that.
A lot of them do it. If you want to keep your job.
So is that what they should do?
This is not what they should do, but a lot of them do it. Did you bear me? That's what they call did you bear me? That's what they call it, and it happens. It's true. It happens all the time because they can't talk and they need the job. Okay, if you told off your boss and you went away, what would you do? Where would you get another job? So, like I said, did you pay me? A lot of them do that, and it's sad, but it goes on all the time. It's been on from the. It's not restricted to Nigeria. It's a global thing.
But they've been able to ward it off through.
Through
various ways, you know, sexual harassment has been, because that's what it is, really.
It is, but it happens all the time, and people put up with it because they don't have. It's like a bad marriage. You can't live a bad marriage if you don't have any alternative.
Because
abroad you have shelters you can run to.
Yes.
You don't have that here.
Mm.
Because if you are abused or if you are ill-treated, you stay there with your children and pray that things will change. Abroad, you have this refuge that you go to. They give you food, they give you protection, they give you legal backing. You don't have all that.
This is a reality check.
It is sad. Mm. And then you see that the more economical, independent the women are, the more they are able to stand. You go to parties these days, and it's mostly women on the dance floor spraying. All the men are relegated to the background because they are, number one, they are tight-fisted. Number two, they've spent all the monies they have on their...
On the woman?
On their second homes and third homes and all that. And by the time they are in their 50s, they are nursing prostate cancer, they are nursing erectile problems and all that. So they just sit quietly at a party, and once they see action on the dance floor, they sneak off.
Really?
Do you ask?
Why are you looking at me as if I do that?
No, we are talking now.
But you're looking at.
Did you start by looking at each other? Why are you so touchy now?
I've done my touchy when you start talking about erectile dysfunction and so on and so forth. I don't have any.
You see these men at the bar, at parties, you know, they dress gorgeously and all that. And you don't know that it's just all window dressing.
And you do not.
Not even the engine knocking, it's the pocket that has knocked. Because in the past, what used to attract you to the dance floor is that so and so is not coming to the dance floor. They'll just put whatever they have for the celebrant in an envelope and give it to him.
And disappear to the back door.
And that's it.
We have a caller. Hello, good afternoon. This is the Discourse. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Can you please speak up a little bit? Yes.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. Very quickly, we don't have much time.
Yeah. I want to contribute to the issue of
that. Just go on and say what you want to say, yes. That's why you called in anyway.
Yeah. My concern is that you do not have the military that is capable of letting these children.
How do you know that? Are you a military man?
I am not, but the manner of the treatment, those
Neither did they form a committee.
But they have the resources. They have the resources to fight.
What are you doing with committee? The president will make a statement and show in his action and his body language and carriage that he did want to rescue the children.
With what?
Crazy things we are doing. Because coming to tell us we are going to go ahead to recruit more military. Who are you recruiting? The unemployed who are not even knowing anything about the quit and not even willing to do the job.
Thank you. Oh, God bless you. Thank you. You know,
they had all these equipments they have and arms. They are not really that sophisticated. I don't know what they do with their grants of votes that they get every year. They said armed robbers have more sophisticated weapons than the so-called military. So what are they going to fight these people
with? Bunmi, you know there was, which governor was it who said that it appeared as if the Boko Haram people were better equipped and better motivated? Do you have a sense that he might be right?
Of course. He must have something to fall back on before making that kind of statement.
So, somebody here says, Abiodunlade says that until corruption is tackled, what we now see is child plays. It will be child play. Where is the money budgeted for security? Let me ask you something.
Let me ask you,
because you've been in information management, both of us are journalists. How come the military announced that they had rescued these girls and gave a number only within 48 hours to retract that statement? What went wrong? What do you think went wrong along the information line?
We've always been fed with rubbish all along. Maybe they thought they would pacify the public, you know, the outcry was out and all that, and they thought why would they say a thing like that when it's not true?
Because
most of the time anything happens, they say, they are in control and all that, until you tune to the foreign media and hear something different. That's their modus operandi every time. Every time anything happens, they feed us wrong information.
Oh my God! Somebody here says, a boy says, Uncle JD, please don't divert from the topic. Please tell us. The truth is that the topic we have various topics, and the truth is I didn't invite the Bunmi initially to talk about. There was no chibok issue on ground when we talked about this program, but We just have to slip it in. So we're trying to do a bit of a mix. And if you sometimes see that, you know, we try to put a bit of humor, it's because we have to lighten ourselves, you know, in reality. We have to. This is going to be a long haul. I think we should be ready for it. It's going to be very long. It's going to be a long haul. To get those girls out, it's going to be a long haul. It's going to call for a lot of dedication. It's going to call for a lot of tactical thinking, which we are not seeing. That is the problem.
We pray that the children too will have tactical
Their own,
plan ways of...
For example, Auntie Bunmi, how come we don't even have the pictures of these girls?
Well, some of the pictures, they said the WAEC is releasing some of the pictures.
Why has it taken this long?
I don't know.
We have a Ministry of Information, for God's sake. That should have been done bang, 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 48 hours.
So we know who we are looking for.
Is it?
We know the people we are looking
exactly.
for.
Exactly, that should have been...
They wanted clearance from this, wanted clearance from that, wanted all this red...
red tape. We should have had a central command that says that, look, okay, how are we going to do it? This
these
is the military
the pictures,
action.
These are the names.
This is the names.
How old are they?
These are the names. These are the pictures. Okay, can we have all the parents in one place? Let's put them in a kind of camp. And let's work on them. Bring
them.
In psychologists, counsel them, and so on and so forth. We've just let them. Look, the sense I get is that there is
very
a lot of activity and nothing is being done.
Nothing.
That's the sense
absolutely
that I get.
Nothing.
I mean, if 3 weeks later we are still talking of committees, we are still talking of the first lady marching to the governor and to the Senate president,
and then the governors will come and take your letter and reply.
It's not going to bring the girls.
Same old song that they are recycling.
Well, Atibumi, it's up to three.
We have to pack and go.
But it's been nice having
it's
you.
Been a pleasure
I wish we had you under better circumstances.
Don't worry, when
things are better, then we'll be able to listen. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been the discourse. Next week, I had the telephone call guarantee this morning that I'll be bringing General Alabi Sama. Of course, you all know General Alabi Sama. He authored the book on the Civil War, and he was one who also let us know that somebody was shot in the buttocks. But General Alabi Sama will come. We'll talk about the book, and then, of course, we'll definitely be talking about security issues, because... You know, he was one of those who flushed out the Maitasine in the 80s, so we might learn one or two things from him. So next week is going to be General Alabi Sama, and I just say, don't touch that dial, okay? So Afrologic will come in anytime from now. Now this, like we do every week, the video of this is going to be on YouTube, and it's going to be on my blog, jimidisu.com. Hopefully, internet willing and God willing, by this time tomorrow. So you'll be able to watch it and, you know, leave your comments, and let's continue this discussion. Our girls must be found. They must be found. Our girls must be found. Our government must show concrete action. We don't want platitudes. We want some concrete action. And if there's no action going on, then let us just be left in peace and let's be praying. You know, if it's an impossible task, tell us. Let us know what it is. I mean, I put myself, God forbid, in place of the mothers and the fathers.
And you
don't know every, because usually you grab at any straw. I think now the country needs a reality check. We need to see something. We don't need platitudes. We don't need any committees for this or that. It's not a committee issue. It's a security issue. We have a commander-in-chief. He should lead us, and he should solve this problem for us, either which way. I believe very strongly that there are groups out there that are experts at doing this thing. I don't think it is intractable. I know that there are groups out there that can be contacted. They will do it. Now is the time for the president, rather than have committees. Now is the time for him to go back and talk to the likes of Babangida, Obasanjo, and Kwa, lock himself up in a room with them and tell me, look, you guys, I need your help on this. I need to sort this problem out. Okay? Because you cannot wish it away, it will not blow away. On that note, have a nice Sunday, whatever is left of your Sunday, and I hope to be with you again this time, same time, next week. Bye.